بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. In this lesson we're going to begin الدرس السابع, the seventh lesson. Inshallah we're going to try and read the whole passage and translate and explain some of the rules that are covered in this passage. This passage is a conversation between a father and his children, sons as well as daughters, as we're going to find out. And the main concept that the author wants to introduce to us, even though we already should know, is the usage of the tum when it's added to the end of the fi'l. When you're speaking to a group of males, for the past tense verb, ذهبتم خرجتم, and also when you're addressing females, ذهبتن خرجتن, if you're addressing them. And when they are speaking about themselves, a group of people are speaking about themselves, the na that's added, the habna, we went, kharajna, we left. These three, dhamair, tum, tunna, and na, are probably the main concept that's going to be covered in this lesson. And then there's some side rules that we're going to also touch upon, inshallah. So let's begin. Al-ab, the father says, أين ذهبتم بعد الدرس يا أبنائي؟ أين ذهبتم بعد الدرس يا أبنائي؟ Where did you all go? He's addressing his sons. Where did you all go? بعد الدرس, after the lesson, oh my sons. أبناء is the plural of ابن. Oh my sons. He's ascribing the sons to himself. He is the father. الأبناء, the sons answer, ذهبنا إلى الملعب. ذهبنا إلى الملعب, we all went to the playground. So if we were to analyze this sentence, this is a jumla فعلية, it begins with a fi'l. ذهب is the fi'l, نا is the fa'il, and then we have جار ومجور, we went to the playground. الأب, the father says, أكرة القدم لعبتم أم كرة السلة؟ أكرة القدم, كرة, كرة is a ball. Qadam is foot. This is mudaf mudaf ilayhi, football. And here likewise, kura means a ball, and salla is basket. This is mudaf mudaf ilayhi, gives you basketball. Kura tasallati is basketball. Kura talqadami is football. So he's asking, did you play this or did you play this? So this is going to be maf'ulun, maf'ulun bihi muqaddam, maf'ulun bihi muqaddam. This is the object of la'ibtum, what did you play? So remember, the original sentence changes when you're asking questions because you bring the thing that you want to find out at the front. So the original sentence would have been لعبتم كرة القدم. لعبتم كرة القدم. But because we want to find out if it's كرة القدم that they played, we bring it forward. So this is the مفعول به مقدم وهو مضاف مضاف إليه. And then لعب is the فعل. تم is the فاعل here, referring to addressing to a group of males. So was it football that you played, am, or كرة السلة؟ Am, in this type of context, it acts as a harf atf, it's a conjunction. So كرة, this is معطوف to كرة, the first كرة. So that's why it's mansub also. وهو مضاف مضاف إليه. So was it football that you played or basketball? الأبناء, لعبنا اليوم كرة القدم. لعبنا اليوم كرة القدم. We played today football, or today we played football. So لعب is the fi'l, na is the fa'il, اليوم is ظرف, كرة is the مفعول به. So here we learn that the مفعول به doesn't always have to come directly after the fi'l. There can be a few words in between, and sometimes it can even come in front of the fi'l, right? Like in this example. So today we played football. لعبنا كرة السلة في الأسبوع الماضي. لعبنا كرة السلة في الأسبوع الماضي. لعبنا, we played كرة السلة. Once again, this is basketball. So this is the مفعول به وهو مضاف مضاف إليه. We played basketball في الأسبوع الماضي, in the previous week. So أسبوع is week. الماضي is past. So this is coming as نعت for أسبوع. الأسبوع الماضي, last week. So we played football today and we played basketball last week. The father now asks الأب, أما ذهبتم إلى المكتبة اليوم؟ أما ذهبتم إلى المكتبة اليوم؟ Didn't you all go to the library today? الأبناء. بلى. Yes. ذهبنا. We went. بلى ذهبنا. Remember, this is a negative question. السؤال المنفي. We answer to affirm. بلى. We use بلى to affirm. Yes, we went. The father now asks, ماذا قرأتم هناك؟ ماذا قرأتم هناك؟ What did you all read over there? What did you all read over there? طيب. الأبناء. The sons. قرأنا الصحف. It will end with a fatha here. He's taking off the fatha because he's expecting you to know that this is maf'ulun bihi, ends with a fatha. And this is what the author does. Gradually, he takes away some of the tashkil once it's been explained in previous lessons. So he's expecting you to already know that this ends with a fatha. قرأنا الصحف. We read. صحيفة is a newspaper. صحف is a plural. We read newspapers. الأب. أسمعتم الأخبار من الإذاعة اليوم. أسمعتم. Did you all hear? This meme has a سكون. سمعتم. And then the lam on the next word starts with a سكون. So there's التقاء الساكنين. When there's التقاء الساكنين involving the meme, this meme here, it takes a ضمّة. The meme takes a ضمّة to come out of التقاء الساكنين. طيب. Usually we've seen that when there's التقاء ساكن, the most common حركة that we give the first ساكن letter is a كسرة. We usually give it a كسرة. منل, قالتل. We usually give it a كسرة. But in this case, they give it a ضمة rather than a كسرة. We say, أسمعتم الأخبار. Did you all hear the news? خبر is one news. أخبار is the plural. من الإذاعة اليوم. الإذاعة.
Radio station.
اليوم today. أسمعتم الأخبار من الإذاعة اليوم. Did you all hear the news from the radio station today? The sons say, الأبناء, نعم, yes, سمعناها, سمعناها, yes, we heard it. So, سمع is the فعل, نا is the فاعل, and ها is the مفعول به. سمعناها, going back to the أخبار. أخبار is a plural, non-intellectual thing. So it's referred to as a singular feminine. So سمعناها, we heard it, يعني we heard the news. الأب, من أي إذاعة سمعتم؟ من أي إذاعة سمعتم؟ From which radio station did you hear it? الأبناء, سمعنا من ثلاث إذاعات. سمعنا, we heard, من, from, ثلاث three إذاعاتٍ, from three radio stations. Remember the rules from 3 to 10. See how إذاعة is مؤنث, so they've made the number مذكر. It opposes from 3 to 10. So we heard from three radio stations, and this إذاعات is the plural of إذاعة. We listened from three radio stations. من إذاعة الرياضي. من إذاعة الرياضي, from the Riyadh radio station. وإذاعة القاهرة. وإذاعة القاهرة, and Cairo radio station. وإذاعة لندن. وإذاعة لندن, and the London radio station. So here we have the three radio stations that they listen to it. And the إذاعة, both of these are معطوف to the first one. The first one is مجور, من إذاعة. و carries the حكم. واو carries the ruling from the previous to this one. So this one takes its إعراب from the first one. And likewise, this one takes its i'rab from the first one, min idaati. That's why they're majrur. Ma'tuf. When you say ma'tuf, you go back to the thing that is ma'tuf to and see the i'rab of that, and then apply the same i'rab onto that word that is ma'tuf. Al-ab. Sami'tu anna. Sami'tu anna is similar to adhunnu anna. I think that. Sami'tu anna, I heard that. طيب, سمعت أن, I heard that. And then when you bring أن, remember that it is from the sisters of إن. So the rules of إن apply. It makes the اسم منصوب and the خبر مرفوع. So I heard, سمعت أن بلالا, بلالا اسم أن, مريض خبر أن. سمعت أن بلالا مريض. I heard that بلال is sick. وأنه في المستشفى, and that he is in the hospital. So this ha is the ism of anna, and fil mustashfa is the khabar of anna. So I heard that Bilal is sick and that he is in hospital. Asahihun hadha, is this true? Asahihun hadha, is this true? الأبناء. نعم. Yes. هذا صحيح. This is true. شفاه الله. شفاه الله. May Allah cure him. May Allah cure him. طيب. Here we have شفا. Let's write this down. شفا, that's the فعل. And then الله is the فاعل. And then we have بلالا. بلالا. So we have فعل, فاعل, and then مفعول به. فعل, فاعل, مفعول به. We've mentioned previously that the فاعل can come as a normal noun like this, or it can be represented as a pronoun, as a ضمير. And likewise, the مفعول به can come as a normal noun like this, or it can be represented as a ضمير. In this case, they've chosen to represent the مفعول به as a ضمير. So in this case, because we're speaking about بلال singular male, the ضمير, ضمير نصب, the most appropriate one is who. طيب, so that's what's going to represent بلال. So we don't need to mention بلال, we're going to represent him as a ضمير instead. When this happens, where the فاعل is a normal noun and the مفعول به is a ضمير, it's wajib for the مفعول به to attach onto the فعل. So it comes before the فاعل and it attaches onto the end of the فعل. It has to come here because it can't stand alone like this. If it's one of these type of متصل ضمائر, it can't stand alone like this, which is why we have to do this now. So شفا, whenever this comes in the middle, it looks like this. But if it comes at the end, then it remains the same. طيب. So we have شفاه. This ها can be written like this if it's joining, or it's written like this if there's no joining, like a O. So شفاه الله. This is the sentence here. شفا is the فعل. The هو, this ها is the مفعول به مقدم. الله is the فاعل. مؤخر, delayed. Likewise, we use the words delayed and مقدم in these type of إعراب when we're analyzing these, because the original sentence is فعل فاعل مفعول به. So if there's any change, we need to say مقدم مؤخر to represent the changes that's occurred. So that's where we got شفاه الله from. So شفاه الله literally means Allah cured him. It means Allah cured him. It's a فعل ماضي, past tense verb. It's already happened. But sometimes these type of verbs, the فعل ماضي verbs, are used in expressing dua, to supplicate. So here it doesn't mean Allah has already cured him. This is a supplication now. May Allah cure him. You're supplicating. And it's the same with جزاك الله خيرا. جزاء is a فعل ماضي. And the same with بارك. May Allah bless you. It means Allah blessed you already. جزاك, Allah already rewarded you. But that's not how we translate it when it comes to du'as. If it's a du'a, what's meant is du'a, then we say, may Allah reward you, may Allah bless you, may Allah cure you in this case. طيب, شفاه الله, may Allah cure him. So the father says, Al-Ab, Ameen. Ameen means, Allahumma stajib, or Allah respond, or Allah answer the du'a. That's what Ameen means. متى دخل المستشفى, when did he enter the hospital? Al-Abna, دخل قبل ثلاثة أيام. دخل قبل ثلاثة أيام. He entered three days ago. So دخل is the فعل. The فاعل, we look for it. If it's not there, then we assume that it is hidden. هو. دخل. The فاعل is هو. It's a hidden ضمير. هو going back to بلال. قبل is a ظرف in this case. ظرف زمان. وهو مضاف. مضاف إليه. And then ثلاثة is مضاف also. And then أيام is مضاف إليه. دخل قبل ثلاثة أيام. He entered 3 days ago. الأب, أين الكتاب ذو الغلاف الأحمر الذي كان في غرفتي؟ أين الكتاب, where is the book, ذو الغلاف الأحمر, which possesses, which has, that's what ذو comes from, right, possesses, has. الغلاف means cover, the cover. الأحمر, which has a red cover, so this is نعت for الغلاف, the red cover. Where is the book with the red cover? الذي كان في غرفتي, which was in my room. Kana means was. In my room, fi ghurfati. So where is the book with the red cover that was in my room? The one of the rules that he's going to teach us here is, now we have al-kitab. Al-kitab. The na'at for al-kitab is dhu. Dhu. And we mentioned that from the things that the na'at and man'ut have to match in is being definite. So this has alif lam. So this one should also be definite. But this is always mudaf. Dhu is always mudaf. So it doesn't take alif lam. It doesn't take alif lam. So what we do in this type of situation where dhu is coming as a na'at for something which has alif lam, to overcome that hurdle of not being able to give dhu al, we give the word after it al instead. We give the word after it al. So dhu is going to be mudaf to something. That thing that it is mudaf to, we give that al instead. We can't say al kitab adhu. Instead of doing that, we give the word after it, the mudaf ilayhi al. So al kitab dhul ghilafi. This way, we've made it definite. Because we mentioned previously that if you make something mudaf to something which is definite, that thing becomes definite as well. So if you say qalamun, that's nakira. You say qalamu Muhammad, Muhammad's pen. Qalam now is ma'rifa, because you've made it mudaf to something which is ma'rifa. When you make something mudaf to something which is ma'rifa, it becomes ma'rifa. So this has become ma'rifa because we've made it mudaf to something which has al. So that's why these two, they match. This is ma'rifa because it has al, and this is ma'rifa because it's mudaf to something which has al. So that's how we overcome the hurdle of not being able to have al on it. So where is the book that has a red cover? الَّذِي كَانَ فِي غُرْفَتِي, which was in my room. كَانَ, remember, is similar to لَيْسَ. We have كَانَ and its sisters, إِنَّ and its sisters. Remember, كَانَ and its sisters, they do the opposite job as إِنَّ and its sisters. And from the sisters of كَانَ is لَيْسَ. And there's 13 of them, and all of them are فِعْل. All of them are verbs. These ones are all verbs. And we mentioned that rather than look for a fa'il after it, because verbs have fa'il, right? These types of verbs, kana and isis, the 13 of them, they don't have fa'il. Instead, we look for ismu kana and khabaru kana. Ismu kana and khabaru kana. طيب. So, ayn al-kitab dhul ghilafi al-ahmar alladhi kana fi ghurfati, which was in my room. So, if we look for ismu kana in this kind of situation, the way we look for ismu kana is the same way we look for the fa'il. So this is, imagine this was ذهبa. ذهبa, where's the fa'il? There's no fa'il mentioned, so it's mustatir. So it's hidden, and it goes back to huwa. Likewise here, ismu kana is huwa, going back to the kitab that he's talking about. الَّذِي كَانَ huwa, the kitab. فِي غُرْفَتِي جَارُ مَجُوشِ بُجُمْلَ خَبَرُ كَانَ. So ismu kana is huwa, خَبَرُ كَانَ is فِي غُرْفَتِي. So where is the book with the red cover that was in my room? أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُ. أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُ, did you all see it? أَرَأَيْتُم, so we have أَرَأَيْتُم, did you all see? So when we attach a ضمير نصب to the end of a verb that has تُم, أَرَأَيْتُم, we add a واو in between. We add a واو in between to make it easy to pronounce. Rather than say أَرَأَيْتُمْهُ, that's how it's supposed to be originally, right? أَرَأَيْتُم, and then we bring the ها, أَرَأَيْتُمْهُ. Rather than say that, we say أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُ. And the same for all of the ones that have has. So أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُ, did you see it? أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُمَا, did you see the two of them? أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُمْ, did you see them? أَرَأَيْتُمُوهَا, if it's feminine, أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُمَا to أَرَأَيْتُمُوهُنَّ, did you see them, if it's a group of females that we're talking about. So this wow is not a dhamir, it's just a harf that's added to make it easy for us to pronounce. Muhu. Muhu is easier than say ra'aytumhu. Tayyib. Yusuf, who I'm guessing is one of the sons, says, ana akhadhtuhu. Ana akhadhtuhu. I took it. Akhadha is the fi'l. Akhadha. Tu is the fa'il. Akhadha is the fi'l. Tu, this ta is the fa'il, and the ha is the maf'ulun bihi. Ha is the maf'ulun bihi, going back to the book. I took it. Al-barihata. Al-bariha means last night. I took it last night. This is dharf, zaman. That's why it's ending with a fatha. Ana akhadhtuhu al-barihata. I took it last night. Wa qara'tu nisfahu. Wa qara'tu, and I read nisfa, half of it. Nisfahu, half of it. So nisfa here is coming as maf'ulun bihi for qara'a. I read nisfa. I read half of it. وهو مضاف مضاف إليه. طيب. الأب. وأين المجلة التي كانت تحت ذاك الكتاب؟ وأين المجلة؟ And where Where is the magazine? مجلة magazine. التي which كانت was under تحت ذاك الكتاب which was under that book. وأين المجلة التي كانت تحت ذاك المكتب ذاك الكتاب. And where is the magazine that was under that book? The اسم كان in this case we'd look for it. If it's not there, then we assume that it's here. Just like a normal verb, ذهبت. We assume it's there. If it's not, then it's going to be here that's hidden. So اسم كانت in this case, or اسم كان in this case is here. Here. And then تحت ذاك الكتاب, this is شبه جملة, ظرف, وهو مضاف, مضاف إليه. And then this is بدل, is the خبر كان, خبر كان. So where is the magazine that was under that, that was under that book? And kana, it changes the tense of the sentence to madi. It makes it was. So Muhammadun Muhandisun, for example. Muhammadun Muhandisun. Muhammad is an engineer. He is currently an engineer. But if you say kana Muhammadun Muhandisan, Muhammad was an engineer. It takes it to the past. That is, it was in the past. That's what kana does. It ascribes the khabar to the mubtada in the past. So that's why he said, which was. So it's no longer there. Where is the magazine that was under the book? It's no longer there. Bilal says, أَهَذِهِ هِيَ أَهَذِهِ هِيَ Is this it? يعني the majalla. Al-Ab says, لا. No. المجلّة ذات الغلاف الأصفري. المجلّة ذات الغلاف الأصفري. No. The magazine that has a yellow cover. So that is the feminine equivalent of ذو. So that likewise the same thing that we did with ذو, we can't give this أل, so we give the word after it أل, because the thing that is the منعوت has أل, so we need to do that. So the same thing applies here. المجلة ذات الغلاف الأصفري. The magazine with the yellow cover is the one that I'm referring to. مروان, who's also one of the sons, هي عندي. It is with me. The مجلة, it, we refer to as here. So we're not going to translate as she. We say it, عندي, is with me. عند is ظرف مكان. وهو مضاف, مضاف إليه. هي عندي, it is with me. أخذتها اليوم. أخذتها اليوم. I took it today. أخذ is the فعل. The تا is the فاعل. The ها, going back to مجلة, is the مفعول به. اليوم is ظرف. ظرف زمان. طيب. يرن الجرس فيقوم مروان ويفتح الباب وتدخل أخواته. يرن is فعل مضارع for رن. رن means to ring. يرن is ringing. What's ringing? الجرس. جرس is the bell. So this is the فاعل for يرن. Something is ringing. What is that thing that's ringing? The bell. So the bell is ringing currently. That's what فعل مضارع indicates, right? Present tense. So while they're having this discussion, the bell rings. فَيَقُومُ so Marwan gets up. This is present tense verb. يَقُومُ قَامَ is the madi. قَامَ he stood. يَقُومُ he's standing now. Marwan is the fa'il. So Marwan stood up. وَيَفْتَحُ and he opens the door. يَفْتَحُ is the fi'il mudari for فَتَحَ. فَتَحَ يَفْتَحُ. الْبَابَ is the maf'ulun bihi for يَفْتَحُ. So he's opening the door. وَتَدْخُلُ أَخَوَاتُهُ and then his sisters. أخواته is the فاعل for this. Enter. So دخل يدخل. But when you're speaking about females, we say تدخل. تدخل أخواته, his sisters enter. So the bell rings. يرن الجرس. فيقوم مروان. So مروان stands. ويفتح الباب and he opens the door. وتدخل أخواته and his sisters enter. So البنات. البنات the daughters. So these are مروان's sisters. They are the father's daughters. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الجميع, everyone. الجميع means everyone answers. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الأب, the father says, أين ذهبتن يا بناتي? Where did you all go, all my daughters? So this is one of the ضمائر that we're supposed to be practicing. تن, also when you're addressing a group of females. أين ذهبتن يا بناتي? Where did you all go, all my daughters? The daughters, البنات, say, ذهبنا لزيارة المديرة. We went to visit the headmistress. So, ذهبنا, the noon, نا, when you're speaking about yourselves, a group of people, first person, plural, is the same for both males and females. They were using na, the boys, when they were speaking about themselves, right? قَرَأْنَا الصُّحُفَ, when they were speaking about themselves. سَمِعْنَا, so the males use na and the females use na. That's one of the things that he wants you to understand in this lesson. If you haven't already understood it, we should already be a step ahead, inshallah, because we've already covered all of these dhamair. But if you haven't already understood, then this is the time that you need to understand this mas'ala, this issue. Dhahabna, we all went. Li comes for ta'lil, right? It's a harf jar, but the meaning is for the purpose of. Ziyarati is ism majur. So harf jar, ism majur, and this is mudaf, and then mudirat is mudaf ilayhi. Dhahabna li ziyarati al-mudirati. We went to, for the sake of visiting the headmistress. Or you can say, we went to visit the headmistress. Al-ab asks, amashaytunna am dhahabtunna bisayyarati? Amashaytunna. The fi'l here is masha. Masha. Just like shafa. Same way. Masha. Masha. طيب. That's the fi'l madi. طيب. Amashaytunna. Did you all walk? Or dhahabtunna bisayyarati? Or did you go with the car? Did you walk to the headmistress or did you go by car? Albanatu mashayna. Mashayna, we all walked. Li anna, because. And then anna is from the sisters of inna, remember. So, baytaha. Mashayna, we walked. Li anna baytaha, because her house, the headmistress, qaribun, is close. So, bayta is ismu anna, wa huwa mudaf, mudaf ilayhi, qaribun is khabaru anna. We walked because her house is close, min madrasatina, close to our school. Huwa, the house, bayna al-masjidi wal-madrasati. It is between, bayna means between. So this is also a dharf. In this case, is some a place, so it's dharf makan. It is between the masjid and the school. So it's a walking distance, that's why they walked. طيب. Then al-ab says, awajad. Tunnaha, awajadtunnaha fil bayti. Did you find her in the house? The fi'l here is wajada. Wajada. Wajada means to find. Wajada means to find. Wajadtunna, you all found. But he asking the questions of Hamza came at the start. Awajadtunna, did you all find ha? And then ha, this ha is the maf'ulun bihi. Going back to the headmistress, al-mudira. Did you all find her? So, tunna is the fa'il, and then ha is the maf'ulun bihi. Wajada is the fi'il. Did you all find her in the house? Al-banat, na'am. Wajadna, we found her. Ha, we found her. Jalasna indaha thulutha sa'atin wa kharajna min baytiha fi sa'atil khamisa. Jalasna. We sat عندها, with her. جلسنا عندها, we sat with her. So this is ظرف مكان. ثلث ساعة. ثلث is a third of an hour. So 20 minutes. We sat with her 20 minutes. ثلث ساعة, a third of an hour. One third of an hour. So this is ظرف زمان. This is ظرف زمان وهو مضاف, مضاف إليه. So we sat with her a third of an hour, which is 20 minutes. وَخَرَجْنَا, and then we left. مِن بَيْتِهَا, from her house. مِن بَيْتِهَا, from her house. فِي السَّاعَةِ الْخَامِسَةِ, at سَاعَةِ الْخَامِسَةِ, 5 o'clock. We say السَّاعَةِ الْخَامِسَةِ. It comes as نَعْتُ وَمَنْعُوتُ when you speak about the hours in the Arabic language. السَّاعَةُ الْوَاحِدَةُ is 1 o'clock. And it's the ordinal numbers, right? The first hour. Literal translation is the first hour. As-sa'atu thaniya, the second hour. But when you translate to English, it's at 2 o'clock. So here, sa'ah khamisa is at 5 o'clock. At 5 o'clock. But literal translation is at the fifth hour, because these are ordinal numbers. Fa'il. And fa'ilah is the mu'annath form. So we sat with her for 20 minutes and then we left from her house at 5 o'clock. طيب, al-um. The mother now is asking, أرأيتن المكنسة يا بنات؟ أرأيتن, did you all see, المكنسة is the broom. مكنسة is the broom. So مكنسة is what was seen. She's asking if they've seen it. So that's the مفعول به. يا بنات, did you all see the broom, oh my daughters? يا بنات, oh daughters. بحثت, so the فعل here is بحثة. بحثت عنها كثيرا. I searched, I looked. عن, I looked for, I searched for. بحث means to search or to look for something. So بحثت, the mother speaking. بحثت, I searched. So بحث is the فعل, the تا is the فاعل. عن is حرف جر. ها goes back to the مكنسة, اسم مجرور. عن ها, for it. So بحث comes with عن. Remember, there's some verbs which come with particular حروف الجر after them. So you have to memorize it like this. بحث comes with عن. بحث comes with عن. I looked for. بحثت عنها. I searched for it. I looked for it. كثيرا. A lot. I looked for it a lot. وما وجدتها. وما وجدتها. And I did not find it. ما, the حرف نفي, negation. وجدت. وجد is the فعل, right? We just mentioned. To find. وجدتها. I did not find it. So I looked for it a lot, but I could not find it. سعاد, one of the daughters, says, أنا وضعتها تحت السلم هذا الصباح. I, وضع is the فعل here. وضع means to place. وضع means to place. أنا وضعتها, I placed it, the مكنسة, I placed it تحت السلم, under the ladder. سلم is ladder. So I placed it under the ladder, هذا الصباح, this morning. We mentioned this rule in the previous lesson when we was reading the, when doing the exercises. We said that if the ismul ishara comes before a dharf, then the ismul ishara is going to take the place of the dharf. So this is the dharf in this case. أنا وضعتها تحت السلم, هذا is the dharf. And then this has alif lam, ismul ishara. After ismul ishara is going to be badal. So if this is dharf mansub, it's mansub. So this is also going to have a fatha because it's mubdal minhu. So I placed it under the staircase or the ladder this morning. Marwan, Ya Ummi, O my mother, أفي الثلاجة ماء بارد؟ أفي الثلاجة ماء بارد؟ Is there cold water in the fridge? نحن عطاش. نحن عطاش. We are thirsty. And this is the plural of عطشان. Or it could be the plural of عطشا as well. Remember, عطشا, which is the feminine, and عطشان, the masculine, both are pluralized using the same form, عطاش فعال. We are all thirsty. So perhaps he's speaking about the males and the females all together, everyone is thirsty. الأم, the mother, says أبشر. أبشر is rejoice, glad tidings. And you're giving someone glad tidings. This is a فعل أمر. فعل أمر. The ماضي is أبشر. أبشر. أبشر, he rejoiced, he was happy, he was delighted. You're telling someone, be happy, rejoice, I give you good news. فيها ماء بارد. In it, in the fridge, يعني فيها, going back to the fridge, in it, there is cold water. There's cold water in the fridge. وعصير برتقال. عصير means juice. برتقال means orange. So, عصير برتقال مضاف مضاف إليه, orange juice. عصير تفاح, apple juice. عصير عنب, grape juice. Yeah, عصير, something that's been squeezed, juice of something. عصير برتقال, and there is orange juice. So cold water and orange juice are in the fridge. طيب, بارك الله فيكم. We finished reading the text. The homework, تمارين, is to do the first. The first four exercises as homework. طيب. So the first one, أجب الأسئلة الآتية, answer the following questions. And these questions are based on the passage that we read. And likewise, ضع هذه العلامة أمام الجمل الصحيحة وهذه العلامة أمام الجمل التي ليست صحيحة. The tick in front of the ones that are correct and the cross in front of the incorrect sentences. And these are also based on the sentence. Then number three, أجب عن الأسئلة الآتية, answer the following questions. هذه الأسئلة ليست مبنية على الدرس السابع. But these questions are not based on the lesson, so you have to answer it with your own sentences. You have to improvise. Number four, أنث الفاعل في كل من الجمل الآتية. Make مؤنث the فاعل in all of the following sentences. So شربتم, شربتن. Similar exercise we did before. ذهبت, we change it to ذهبتي. طيب, that's exercise number four. Should we continue? طيب, we'll stop. We'll stop on exercise number four. طيب, so that's homework. Exercise 1, 2, 3, and 4. بارك الله فيكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.